everyone. Wanted to bring you along today for a tour of the garden in the month of January. We've been doing a lot of garden projects lately on videos, and a lot of you have asked how things are going. So wanted to combine the garden tour with the updates and then share some tips along the way. Well, first update is the garlic. Now, we planted the garlic a couple of months ago, and I planted a more heat-tolerant variety, and it is growing absolutely beautifully. Lots and lots of garlic shoots, and I'm really looking forward to harvesting garlic in the late spring. Now, right next to the garlic is the massive eggplant that we harvested over the summertime. And honestly, guys, we have been battling super high winds, and this is definitely feeling the effects of it. The leaves are getting shredded, they're getting dried out by the high winds. We've also had some temperature swings, a lot of heat, and then a lot of cold nights. So it's definitely suffering some cold damage, but it is still surviving. And I'm seeing down here some little buds that are starting to form again, so I'm really excited about that. Probably what I'm gonna do with this plant is prune it back this week, and hopefully that will encourage some new growth and some more eggplant. Down here is this big bag Smart Pots container, and I have been battling rabbits, slugs, and birds in this one. I actually planted a lettuce spiral, had to seed it a second time because it got completely eaten, and last week there were birds and bunnies in here, so I put this little wire mesh fence over here in hopes to protect it. So I've got some seedlings that are starting to come up, so we'll see how it goes. You know, that's the way gardening goes. You win some, you lose some. I've got the carrots that we planted on a how to grow lots of carrots video. They're looking fabulous. They need some thinning. I'm a little bit behind on some of my garden day-to-day activities just because of the holidays, Christmas and New Year's, but don't these look absolutely gorgeous? Oh, I love the green color, and I'm gonna get in here this week and thin these out so I can grow lots of nice carrots. I mean, after all, I gotta follow my own advice, right? Now right over here is the flower tower. You might remember this from last summer. We basically stacked up three different sizes of Smart Pots containers and planted these Sun Patience flowers in here, which are absolutely gorgeous. Now, Sun Patience are a type of impatiens, but they do well in the sun and in the shade. And I'm super excited. They're lasting through the winter time. We haven't had a frost. They're starting to bloom and they look absolutely gorgeous. So it's a really fun project to pretty up an area. And you can grow anything in it, really. Lettuce, spinach, I mean, any kind of greens that would kind of drape over. So let me know if you're gonna plant one in your garden as well. Well, I've been meaning to get these butternut squash harvested for a while, so now is as good a time as any to do it. I've had a really hard time harvesting these because I love seeing them on this trellis, but obviously they are ready. These have been so much fun to grow over the summer into the winter time. And I'm almost out of the butternut squash in the house, so I'm gonna cook some of these up today. See, the vines are all dried up. Oh, this one's split. This one might not be any good, but it'll be pretty for decorations. Oh, that one just fell right off. Always fun to harvest in the winter time. Now, this garden bed is one of my main garden beds in the winter time that gets sun, because the majority of my garden is shaded in the winter. So in here, I have some peas planted. Let me go around and show you the peas. Got peas, nasturtium, sunflowers, and with the rain that we had last week, they're doing really well. It's always an adventure climbing in here. I love these peas. The purple flower is so, so pretty. These are purple magnolia peas, and they're climbing up beautifully up this trellis. They've loved the rain we've had lately. I'm hoping they just keep on growing, keep on flowering, and trying to see if I have any peas yet. Don't think I do. Now, it's been a really crazy winter. I mean, I've never had a sunflower growing in the winter before. That's what 90, 95 degree temperatures will do throughout November and December. A big surprise for me this winter is this little tomato plant. I believe this is a Tidy Treats tomato, but I really didn't expect it to do that well over the winter time. But look at this stalk here. It's super, super stocky, and it's got some flowers on it. Let's see if I can get you guys a good shot of the flowers, which absolutely amazes me. I mean, our nights have been in the 50s and the 40s, and this tomato is just still going strong. Next, the veggie pod. Super excited how things are going in here. This is really providing the vegetables with a little bit of heat. For example, the tomato. This is a yellow pear tomato. And look at that, little baby tomatoes in the middle of January. And got a lot of other things going on in here. This patio baby eggplant is perfect for the container, and it's got some little baby eggplant on it. Beautiful Mizuna Red Streaks mustard. I love this, it's delicious in salads. Some dill, which is a great cool weather herb, so make sure you get your cool weather herbs planted. Look at the peppers. These are gorgeous peppers. This is, I'm not sure what type it is, but I know it's the All American Selections winner. And the red mustard, we have been harvesting this for several months, absolutely loving it in salads. This is the All America Selections Katarina cabbage. So if you're looking for a good container variety, pretty quick maturing and absolutely gorgeous, nice small heads. I just planted a couple of weeks ago some lettuce. I've got some seedlings coming up, some super red romaine, salad bowl. Oh, this is gonna be so delicious to harvest in just a couple of weeks. And some tango lettuce, which is a new variety for me this year. Quick little tip on the kale right here. I just basically chopped this kale back to the stems. And the reason for that was there was a lot of bugs going on in here. But don't pull your kale out. If it gets buggy, if it gets wilted, if it gets just to where it's not looking good, cut it off like this, and you can see I'm already seeing some new growth here. So I think I've cut this one back 3 or 4 times, and it always grows right back and gives me lots more kale. In the center area of my garden here is my peppers. If you've been following my garden tour videos, you've seen this before. The peppers are still thriving and doing absolutely beautiful. In fact, here's one that needs harvesting. Look at that pepper, isn't that gorgeous? Beautiful. Now the peppers are suffering a little bit of cold damage on the leaves here, you can see. So I probably will be pruning some of these back, and that way they'll push out some new growth for the spring. Oops, here's a little one back here that, oh, this one fell off. This one's a little shriveled up, but it'll be good for saving seeds. So let's move around here, the pepper planter. A lot more peppers on here. We're not gonna do a pepper harvest today, but let me just show you real quick here. I can't resist. The poblanos. Oh my goodness. These are looking beautiful. Are those gorgeous or what? Now on the hill here in the wintertime, I hardly get any sun, so it's a lot different than the summer. So basically my goal is to keep it covered. I've got some peas planted right here where I have tomatoes growing. Still have some tomato plants left, so that's always exciting. Couple little tomatoes still on here. Some flowers starting to come out, so that's pretty cool. And in here I planted some arugula. Again, just trying to get it covered. So I planted some seeds a few weeks ago, but unfortunately I've noticed the birds poking through the soil and picking out the seedlings. I put this tomato plant in here just to protect it from like people walking through or the dog walking through, but I wanna put some of that little holographic tape on here to scare the birds away. And the nasturtiums starting to come in. They're looking really, really pretty. Look at these flowers, so gorgeous. I love how it drapes over the edge here. And by the way, if you're liking my videos, make sure you hit the like button, share it with your friends, and subscribe so you don't miss the next one. And basically a few weeks ago, I just got out here and laid down a whole bunch of seeds. And I did a bunch of arugula because arugula grows so fast, grows well in the shade. And with the recent rains we've had, all the little seedlings are starting to come up. So hopefully the birds and the bunnies stay away from these. Now on the side over here, what I did, I think back in November, is I planted a whole bunch of wildflower seeds. You can see they're all starting to come up there, so I'm pretty excited about that. Now that is gonna give my garden a beautiful burst of color first thing in the spring, or hopefully very soon. Now a lot of you have asked about how I plant my flowers. That's basically how I do it. Plant it early. If you live in Southern California, get some wildflower seeds planted right now and you're gonna have flowers the first part of spring. Now things do tend to grow very, very slowly on the hill here in the wintertime. Again, because we're not getting any sun, the temperatures are a little bit colder. Up here is where I planted the cover crops. On a video a few months back, planted some red crimson clover, some white Dutch clover, starting to grow in slowly, but it's definitely starting to grow. Remember those peas I planted on that same video? Here we go, guys. Looking forward to more pea harvest coming soon. That pretty much hits the highlights of what's growing on the hill here. Can't wait, couple months, warm weather vegetables will be out here. Let's go check out the area where the red planters are. Over here is where the mint and the celery are. And we trimmed back this mint a couple of weeks ago. Remember, I told you guys, it's gonna grow right back. And look, we've got some new little green growth here on the mint. So looking forward to some beautiful new mint leaves pretty soon. And here is the celery plant. I showed this when we planted our celery base from the grocery store. This celery plant has been in here for a couple of years. It gets cut back every year, but it grows right back. It drops seeds, and it's always fun to see the new growth. Now, typically in here at this time of the year, it's filled with parsley, but we haven't had a lot of rain. So the parsley has been growing in very slowly, had a lot of heat, and the parsley loves the cool weather. So basically in here, my goal has been, again, keep the area covered. Got peas planted in here. All these little seedlings are actually celery seedlings, so I'll be pulling some of those out because I don't need that much celery. And this whole area needs trimmed up. I've got some radishes in here, but due to the heat, they haven't done real well. Now, the nasturtiums are just totally taking over in here, so I am going to be thinning some of these out soon as well and probably planting some other types of greens in the other red containers. So the oregano plant here is going crazy. I definitely need to cut it back because I don't need this much oregano. And I'll probably be doing a video on planting some cool weather herbs in this container soon, like cilantro, dill, parsley, and maybe some chives. We just did a video on this lettuce tower a few weeks ago. I planted lettuce in my strawberry crate tower. I've got strawberries on top, lettuce around the sides. It's gonna fill in beautifully. So if you missed that video, make sure you go back and catch it because this is a great way to grow a lot of food in a little bit of space. So make sure you let me know if you've got one planted. Now this little corner of the garden over here is where I did the fall garden series, the late summer garden series, and then it's where I have my grapevine. So thank you for all of your suggestions, by the way, on how to prune the grapevine. We'll be doing a video on that very soon. Now this garden bed is where I did a lot of the fall garden series videos, and honestly, we've had a lot of problems this winter with the rabbits and the rats. So something has pretty much eaten most of my little broccoli shoots. This is the broccoli artwork, the All America Selections winter artwork broccoli. And I had lots of side shoots and they got eaten, so I was really disappointed about that. But there are some more coming out, so that's exciting. The pak choi here, this beautiful Bopak pak choi, the hot weather, it's going to seed, but we've got some more planted inside the house, so hopefully we'll be able to replace these plants. The Katarina cabbage in here, the prism kale, oh my gosh, I love this kale, it's so pretty. And down at the end there, we planted some radishes, and again, as soon as they come up out of the ground, they get eaten. So we're hoping to get that problem solved soon, but it's been a battle. The garden bed right next to me is where we did the late summer garden, and this one does need some trimming up. I'm leaving some of the red profusion zinnias in because I want them to dry up so I can harvest the seeds. And that's a good little tip for you gardeners, is just leave a lot of your plants in and let the seeds dry right on the plant. And look at that, these are all seeds. So sometimes I'll just go ahead and sprinkle them right back in the garden bed. Cover them with a little bit of soil to get some new little seeds planted. On the container deck edible garden I planted on a video a few weeks ago, I'm telling you guys, I am loving how this is growing in. It's really nice to look outside my kitchen window and see the beautiful flowers, the beautiful vegetables that are growing in. Someone asked me, are these just for ornamental use or are you actually going to be able to eat them? I am going to be able to eat them. The lettuce is growing beautifully. I've got a couple broccoli plants in here. The cilantro is almost ready to harvest. And the container here with the trellis, oh, I absolutely love it. Now the peas have taken some beating with the wind we've had the past couple of days, but I just love looking outside my window and seeing this beautiful container garden. So make sure you let me know if you've got one planted. The wall saddle planters are a great way to save some space and really enjoying how this is filling in. It was a lot of fun to show you around the garden today. I hope you enjoyed the garden tour. It was really fun to get some harvest also while I'm out there. Looking forward to spring gardening season just around the corner. We'll have lots of new videos. Can't wait to get those warm weather vegetables started. So let me know down below how things are going for you, how you like the garden tour. I'm really looking forward to reading your comments. Thanks so much for watching. We'll see you on the next video.